When should a person cooperate? When should a person be selfish? What about nations? And how does science play a role? Robert Axelrod is a political scientist who uses game theory to study human behavior.
The Cuban Missile Crisis happening while I was in college, looking around for something useful to do with mathematics, certainly had an influence on me. I thought this is nuts that people would be willing to risk hundreds of millions of lives for where these missiles are based when it didn't matter where they were based. I thought, maybe there's something to understand here that isn't obvious.
Axelrod became intrigued by The Prisoner's Dilemma, a classic game theory scenario involving two threatened players. Each can choose self-preservation at the expense of the other.
So I thought of the idea of having people submit computer programs to play a game that's very simple but represents the problem of the conflict between making short-run gains by being selfish and seeking longer-term gains from cooperating with others. So I was surprised when the simplest of all the strategies submitted was the one that did the best.
Known as tit for tat, a player cooperates in the beginning, then does what the opposing player did on the previous move. Axelrod investigated other strategies of cooperation in the real world.
In World War I, they had something on the Western Front called the live and let live system, where the British and French on one side and the Germans on the other would often do things like shoot their artillery between the trench lines, not on the trench lines.
His book, The Evolution of Cooperation, proposed the role of forgiveness in conflict resolution and included a landmark article co-authored with evolutionary biologist Bill Hamilton.
The one important modification is if there's some possibility of misunderstanding, then you should be somewhat more forgiving once in a while. Well, I was one of the 40 winners of the Westinghouse Science Talent Search, which later became the Intel Talent Search. And they declared us to be the 40 most promising young scientists. I follow my nose, which is to say I scan things widely. When I see something new, I'll try to understand it. So it's being open to new stimuli.